थैंक यू मैम फॉर दोज वेरी केयरिंग वर्ड्स. एंड एक्चुअली बहुत अहम बात है ये, जो ये रिलेशनशिप होता है सिनेमाटोग्राफर.
Even in the trolley shop, without in those days, I remember there was no zoom lens. So that the trolley moment was so smooth, like it really the zoom is coming closer to the artist. So many things like crane shots, and he had one very favorite between him and Gurbetji. There was one trolley man who used to push the trolley. His name was Aziz. I remember he said Aziz available nahi hai to shooting ho because he was so good. So they created so much magic in their work with minimum facilities, you see. And when I think of Kagaz Ke Phool, I feel first thing that comes into my mind, the hero of the movie is Murthy Saab. You know, of course the director was there, everybody was there, the music and everything. But it hits you, so. And the magic he created in black and white is something amazing.
Ma'am, among his entire body of work, if you could recommend, say, the top three or the top five movies to the younger generation, you know, to know what V.K. Murthy Saab was all about, which films would you choose?
And why? I would say Kagaz Ke Phool, Sahar Ke Ghulam, and Pyaasa.
And why now?
Because in Kagaz Ke Phool, the story had such a deep emotions and, you know, pathos that he created on the screen with his black and white photography. And in Sahar Bibi aur Ghulam, those days, you know, 100 years ago, those havelis and, you know, palaces kind of thing. And there is one song where the zamindars are watching a dance sequence. And there is, in the olden days, they used to have those big fans, you know, the pulling, which, you know, that kind of thing. And the light and shade, the way to photograph that is really, and Pyaasa, of course, you know, is very nice. And I must say, I forgot to say this on the stage, that I owe my quite a lot of success to Murthy Saab, because in the beginning, a new artist, especially a girl, has to look pretty, and he made me look pretty.
Also, that was exactly what I was going to say. After this title, this stuff, everybody said that you know, one of the most elegant and beautiful actors that we still have today. A lot of it also because, at that time, some actors did not insist on actresses putting on a lot of makeup or something like that. They wanted to keep them natural.
Yes.
So did that also help? How did that work out? Did you also tell you that, you know, you don't have to put on a lot of makeup? Or?
Being a very absolute newcomer, I didn't know much about makeup, how much to put, how much not to put. So the makeup man did my makeup and I used to put on the set, that's all. I don't know much about it. At that time, he didn't say anything to me. Maybe he told the makeup man less or more, I don't know.
Ma'am, you are undoubtedly an inspiration to many of the women out there, but your mother certainly would have inspired you a lot. So anything that you would like to tell about your mom?
It's not only my mom, but my father also, because so many years ago, you see, and a Muslim family down south, they were not very liberal and broad-minded. So they allowed me to learn Bharatanatyam and perform on stage. And also my mother, not my when I entered the movie, my father was not there anymore. And she was very scared and reluctant, but I said I would do. And fortunately, it so happened that the first producer of the movie I started in Chennai, he knew my father. And my father was a commissioner, so they had someone, you know, do whatever happened. So he came and told my mother, no problem, the things are changed, it's like any other job. Thank you.
First of all, I feel very lucky that Whistling Woods has this opportunity to honor these kind of legends like Baba Sahab, like Mukti Sahab. On personal level, I'm very, very emotional about it, particularly for Mukti Sahab, because Umang was my first film as an actor, and he was a cinematographer, and was so thrilled to work with him because during college days, you know, we used to admire Baba Sahab's photography and Murthy Saab. Like today's generation know too few cinematographers and they appreciate. Because they remember the Ganga Jamuna and those kind of films were made by Baba Sahab and Kagas Ki Phool, Sahabi Bigu Gulam. So I was a big fan of Murthy Saab and I was very happy when I started working as an actor. When I got a picture of Umang, I thought that Murthy Saab is in front of me. I couldn't believe it. लेकिन मैं 1.5 साल के अंदर उनके साथ दोस्त बन गया क्योंकि मैं स्टूडेंट अच्छा था तो उनसे मैंने थोड़ी सी फोटोग्राफी की इंपॉर्टेंस सीख ली थोड़ी मैंने डायरेक्शन भी सीख ली चुपके चुपके एज एन एक्टर होते हुए तो सिनेमाटोग्राफी अच्छी एक जो है वो फिल्म को कितना उभार सकती है एक्टर्स को कितना उभार सकती है वो एक बहुत कम लोगों को मालूम है लेकिन मुझे उस वक्त ये मालूम पड़ा कि सिनेमाटोग्राफर क्या होता है और इसीलिए मैंने अपनी फिल्मों में हमेशा जब मैं सिनेमाटोग्राफी को इंस्ट्रक्शन देता हूँ या शॉर्ट्स कंपोज करता हूँ तो ऐसे लीजेंड्स को मैं याद करता हूँ कि ये होते तो ये कैसे लेते सो इसीलिए वो जो क्लासिक डायमेंशन ऑफ सिनेमाटोग्राफी जो सिनेमा में थी आज भी है लेकिन उस टाइम पे बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट था एक सिनेमाटोग्राफी से मतलब पिक्चर मीन्स फोटोग्राफ प्ले उसके लिए फोटोग्राफर बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट होता था एंड मूर्ति साहब एंड बाबा साहब हैज बीन इंस्टीट्यूशन फॉर ऑल कमिंग जनरेशन हमारी जनरेशन दूसरी जनरेशन आने वाली जनरेशन और मैं बहुत खुश हूँ कि आज उनके लिए ये ट्रिब्यूट जो है YIWICA ने रखा है और हम लोग इसमें शामिल हैं
So for someone to, you know, start analyzing their body of work is a big deal. So if someone you want to introduce these legends to someone and you would recommend a few movies, which movies would you tell them to begin with?
You see, V. Baba Sahab ki the best movie, if I remember, is Ganga Jamuna.
Why?
You see, in Ganga Jamuna, you see the environment of the forest, whether it was an action sequence or an emotional sequence. You could see the great cinematography in it, which enhances the whole storytelling Of course, there was Dilip Kumar Vaidyanathan one. But we could notice, that is why today, till today, Ganga Jamuna is one of the best classic of Indian cinema. But Indian cinema mein agar unka contribution nahi hota to kaise best classic hoti thi? Filmein to bahut chalti hain, lekin jo classic 40 saal tak 50 saal tak rehti hain, unmein sari cheezon ka yogdan hota hai. Particularly cinematography ka, director ka, writer ka, actors ka. Aur Murthy sahab ke main bare mein kahunga ki hum jab film institute mein padhte hain, तो हमें सबसे पहली फिल्म जो दिखाते हैं नए स्टूडेंट को वो है कागज़ की फिल्म. कि ब्लैक एंड वाइट फिल्म के अंदर भी एक सीन, जबकि आप देखते हुए आप कैमरामैन को नोटिस करें, वक्त ने किया क्या हंसी सितम, अगर आप गाना देखें तो आप एक्टर से ज़्यादा आप उसकी सिनेमाटोग्राफी को देखना शुरू करेंगे. मूर्ति साहब को याद करेंगे. साबी भी गुलाम इतनी खूबसूरत फिल्म है, लेकिन आप मूर्ति साहब को देख सकते हैं. यू कैन सी द डिस्टिंक्टिव डिफरेंस between two photographers. That's how they become legion. Thank you.
Sir, aaj ke cinema
ki technology has given you a lot. Ab aapke paas itni choice hai jo in logon ke paas kabhi nahi thi. Lekin ye apne imagination se aur apne artistic temperament se sochte the. Aaj aapke paas agar 100 option hai, lekin aapka aana andar se hi chahiye. You should know one thing, that your soul must speak before technology. टेक्नोलॉजी को चूज करना ही आज एक आर्ट है. तो उसको अगर आप सोल से कनेक्ट कर सकते हैं, उस फोटोग्राफी को, उस सीन्स को, तो यू आर ए ग्रेट सिनेमाटोग्राफर. अदरवाइज तो आप सिर्फ छाप रहे हैं. थैंक यू.
वंडरफुल सर.